AI tools like RotoBrush, scene edit detection, auto captions, and so on have been a huge upgrade to my workflow. And the team over at Adobe have been pushing AI forward even more to enhance our workflows further with things like Generative Fill, which I use constantly. And now we're getting Generate Video. Generate Video is going to be massively helpful for me for things like placeholders, pitch materials, assets, and transitions. The fact that I'll be able to quickly test an idea for my project before committing and putting the time into actually doing it, or extend a clip to give myself that extra beat in an edit, that will all be massive for my workflow. But let's stop talking about it and dive in to see how it works. Jumping right into the Firefly Video app, we have Generate Video. We can type something in the prompt area down here, and we get this AI-generated video that looks like AI. But we can work on our prompt and get more descriptive like this, and we'll get a much better result. But I have found that it tends to do best with animals, text effects, landscapes, and atmospheric elements and special effects. So let's give animals a shot first. Let's start with a simple prompt here, an adorable puppy, because, I mean, who doesn't want that? And we get this, which right off the bat looks pretty solid, but we can get more descriptive with our prompt here. I'll add close-up and some things like extremely realistic, highly detailed, shot on 35mm film, and a few other prompts that will help guide Firefly toward what I'm aiming at. And with that, we are getting something closer to what I wanted, with the hair looking much better than before as well. But we can try to get a bit closer, and I got this one that has even better detail. I could slap on a grade, a little bit of grain, and it's looking pretty solid. Or we could add some action. This time we'll go with an adorable puppy surfing a wave in the ocean, realistic, highly detailed, shot on film, and we receive absolute perfection. Landscapes are working pretty well. Of course, you want to lean into strengths, things that will play well with the way the image tends to shift with AI. So let's try ocean, big waves, storm, and this is pretty good. Although I don't like the camera movement at all. Feels like a drone shot with a mistake in the move. So we'll try getting detailed again with similar words to push us along. So I'll add cinematic, realistic, highly detailed, rough seas, sunset, warm light, lens flare, and shot on film. And that looks pretty great, actually. The backlit look definitely helps a ton. So again, we can toss on a grade and grain, and there you go. The text works far better than I was expecting. I thought I'd have more of what you get from other places, but the text was pretty consistently solid with Firefly. So again, I'll add my prompt here, and we get this cheesy looking corporate stock image type thing. So we'll toss in some extra prompts to dial it in more, and this time I'm gonna add cyberpunk and gritty along with similar extras as before, and we get this. I was surprised by the odd glitching on this one, but unlike other glitch results, this one felt like a style, which I dig. But I'll just change the seed over here and roll it again, and we get this. And we could do that several times. Leave the prompt as is and just shift the seed and see where we land. The thing I'm probably most interested to use Firefly for is assets. This could be something like a transitional element or any other kind of asset. For instance, let's try a large explosion on a black background for compositing. And while cool, this isn't at all what I was thinking. So I'll shift to a large fire explosion and add low angle, realistic, sparks, smoke, and fire. And now we are far closer to what I had in mind and on a black background ready for compositing. And that alone blows my mind. But you can also create lens flares, smoke, muzzle flashes, water elements, and anything else you can think of. As long as you clarify that you want it over a black background, green or blue screen for compositing, you should be able to pull what you're looking for. And you can also start from an image. Next to the prompt box, you can upload an image right here, then turn that into a video. So let's upload this image, then add the prompt cinematic, shot on film, widescreen, and we have our result. We could and should toy around and refine our prompt a little bit more and eventually land on something like this. And something to note here is that Adobe is aware about the ethical concerns regarding AI. So they've trained the Firefly generative AI models on licensed content only, like professional quality Adobe stock content and public domain content where copyright has expired. Meaning it's not being trained on any Adobe user content and is designed to not generate any copyrighted or public figures. So you can create with confidence. But that is a brief overview on Adobe Firefly. We're very much still in the infant stages with generative AI, but the goal here is to use it as a tool to help convey ideas rather than a replacement for the final product. For me, I use these things as a placeholder or a pitch element so then I can go and make something brand new. These features are coming soon to beta, so check the notes for more on that and leave us a comment below to let us know how you would use the technology in your own project. And don't forget to like and subscribe because you can hear a blue whale's heartbeat from over 2 miles away.